Tokio, Sydney, New York, Reuters, Wental Education Group A mit size tutoring services firm in China reported a threefold increase in its 2018 third quarter net income earlier this year. Few people made much of it. A couple walk through the usually busy sunlit Soho shopping district after the city emptied ahead of Chinese New Year in Beijing, China, February 4, 2019. Reuters, Thomas Peter Rather, investors fretted over a weak performance in China from Apple Inc. A classic yardstick for measuring demand in the health of the world's second largest economy. For Brendan Ahern, the New York-based chief investment officer at Kane Funds Advisors, TAS results showed that, while China may be showing signs of pain from a long-running US Sino-trade war, parts of its economy are still doing well. With some study of China, you can get results that are very contrary to this view of China as one entity, said Ahern. Ahern is not alone. Foreign investors keen to get a grasp of China's economy have for years distrusted official data. Many have models built on inputs such as auto sales or air traffic and even indicators such as commentary from food and beauty firms. Many people look for alternative data sources in China as proxies for growth, rather than the used the official figures, said Ross Hutchison, a fund manager at Aberdeen Standard Investments in Edinburgh. I find it helpful to consider micro stories, where you can get a better sense of actual activity. In 2018, even as the trade war zapped exports and investment at home, China's official GDP growth was 6.6%, as always, unerringly within official targets. That was a 28-year low for China, but still almost doubled the global average of 3.7%. There are always questions about it and there are always doubts raised about it, said Michael Oork, Chief Market Strategist at Jones Trading in Greenwich, Connecticut. US investors for the most part put a little haircut on it. If the number is X, they suspect the real number is X minus something, and then it is more about trying to identify the trend of numbers rather than the absolute levels. What's more, for an economy that exceeds $10 trillion, a population of nearly 1.4 billion, analysts say China's economic statistics are released too swiftly for investors to have faith in their accuracy, leading them to read the economic tea leaves elsewhere. China's National Bureau of Statistics did not respond to a fixed request for comment. Fakes, filters around the same time that Apple's disappointing iPhone sales were making investors nervous about China. Aberdeen's Hutchison was looking at athletic apparel firm Nike Inc.'s estimate beating results in double-digit sales growth in China. To me, it suggests that the worries around Apple are not a canary in the coal mine for faltering Chinese goods, but that increasingly expensive iPhones just aren't as cool as they used to be, said Hutchison. Peter Bay, a portfolio manager on the US equity team at UBS Asset Management, agrees some filtering of data is needed. Besides the example of the 2013 crackdown by Chinese authorities on gift giving by officials, which skewed demand for luxury brands. Therefore, China growth numbers out of some high-end brands again weren't that indicative of China consumer health. His discretionary list of data points includes travel commentary from booking platforms as well as commentary from beauty and food companies around the region pandering to Chinese travelers and customers. For US hedge fund manager Teddy Valley, founder of Pevale Global, the correlations between China's credit growth and other markets such as global crude and copper are material, so he looks at China's base money or M1 growth. the issue today is we haven't seen M1's turn higher, so it's quite difficult to be constructive until this turns. Bali said. Graphic Proxy Economic Indicators for China, TMSNRT.RS-2CH1A4IRD-Birds-Eye-View The Economist Magazine's Li Keqiang Index was inspired by comments from the Chinese premier decade or so ago that the official GDP was man-made. Li based his preferred measures of economic growth on bank loans, rail freight and electricity consumption. But as China weans its economy of a reliance on manufacturing and heavy industry, analysts have found the Li Keqiang Index needs additional measures. Unfortunately, China's modern economy, more represented by internet payment platforms and sales systems such as WeChat and Alipay, isn't yet openly sharing data on online traffic. NSHI Cortesi, an Asian Equities Portfolio Manager at GAM Investment Management in Zurich, tracks a China Satellite Manufacturing Index developed by San Francisco-based SpaceNo. It analyzes industrial facilities in China using imagery from space and algorithms measuring the level of manufacturing activity. Qin Weibang, a London-based senior economist at European Asset Manager Amundi, uses in-house models incorporating freight and passenger traffic data, floor space under construction and electricity consumption. Slideshow, 2 images. These data are more independent from official GDP and headline data of high frequency, difficult to manipulate by officials, and cover the relatively broad economy, said Wang. For many analysts like Sarah Shaw, a Sydney-based global portfolio manager at 4D Infrastructure, nothing beats boots on the ground. If you are wandering around in Beijing and you can't get into a restaurant or you can't get on a train because they are all full, that's an indication that things are still relatively okay. Additional Reporting by Chuck Mikulaj, Chuck K. Duguid, Kraus Kopf, Dara Ranasinghe, Caroline Waletkevich and Jennifer Aplan, Writing by Video Ranganathan, Editing by Lincoln Fistur Standards. The Thomson Reuters Trust Principles.